And the one that I think is best is the next day procedure. This is sort of the most important thing to make the solution work. If we can't do this, then we would need to think of a different approach. And the reason that I think this is best is that we can solve this in a simple way for the simple case, which is what we'll do next, not worrying about the complexity of how many days are in different months, and get a good feeling that we're able to get close to the right answer for some cases. The other answer that I think would be okay is leap year. This is something we know we're going to need at some point. We need to determine whether years are leap years to know how many days there are in the month of February. But it's kind of a grungy, painful thing to write. It's something we know we're going to be able to do. And it's something that's not too interesting. So we're going to leave that until later. You could certainly make a case for doing that first. The other two are really not good answers. Trying to do the whole problem at this point is a little early. We still want to break it down into simpler parts and make progress and know that we're making progress. The other one is closer to something reasonable. The problem is this is probably not really the procedure that we want. And until we write these other procedures and think more about how we're going to do this, we might not know enough to implement this correctly. And the reason I'm going to suggest that this is not what we want is the number of days in a month actually depends on the year, if the month is February. So let's start by writing the next day procedure. And to keep things simple, we'll assume that all months have 30 days.